And let's talk to expat Adelaidean, it's Mick Ozzie in Calgary. Hello, Mick.
How you going, Jeff? Good to talk to you. Yeah, as always, lots and lots of going on in the sport, especially over here in North America.
Yeah, mate, first and foremost, commiserations about the Canadian team there in the Olympics.
after six days, we had no medals.
No medals?
It was good at the end, what? So it was all right, you know.
I thought it was very... Someone picked up on a couple of things that... some Canadian commentators were saying, and they were looking at where Canada was on the tally board after the first week, and above you was some country called Togo, and they reckoned up, yeah, Togo were ahead of Canada, and they reckoned up that Canada sent about 260-odd athletes to Beijing. Togo sent two, and they were still ahead of you in the medal tally.
Yeah,
what's going on there?
Oh, as I said last week, the first week it was really bad. It put the whole country down. But then, you know, we come good, and obviously Winter Games is the main thing, and they're all looking forward to 2010 in Vancouver. But yeah, you know, Canadians need to get a bit more of a killer instinct. Like, over here, they're so polite of people, which is a great thing. But, you know, sometimes that carries into sport, and, you know, Aussies, we all go out there to win. Competing is great, but yeah, you're there to win, so
Absolutely.
Canada needs to get a little bit tougher, you know?
Need a bit of a rocket. Now, Mick, something I've never heard about this, and the people who haven't heard our chats before, there's a couple of AFL teams. Well, they're not AFL teams. They're Aussie rules teams in Canada. Now, who are they? Back of the Woods?
Oh, yeah. Oh, well, like I said, Aussie rules exploded overseas in the last 10 years, and Toronto's got the second biggest league outside of Australia behind London, England.
Right.
And then out here in the West, we started like 5 or 6 years ago in Vancouver and Calgary. So, yeah, we played again Saturday. We had the Calgary Bears versus the Calgary Kangaroos. Beautiful 25 degrees summer day. Saturday afternoon, it was just like being at home. And, you know, we were a bit short. We had 12 aside on a close to a full field, but it was fantastic, and, you know, I'm still having a kick, which is a lot of fun.
There you go. Now, something I've never heard of before, this is happening in Melbourne, or tomorrow, apparently, the 2008 International Cup of Aussie Rules Footy. Tell me about that.
Oh, now you've got me excited, and, you know, all the Aussies listen. I know football is the number one thing down home, and I love it. And, you know, you follow the Crows and the Pats and the SANFL and your local team, but seriously, if you love football, get on board with it. The coverage in Melbourne has apparently been really good. The third international cup, the first one was held in 2002 and the Irish boys won it. The second one was in 05 and Kiwi mates across the ocean won it.
What?
And this year is the third time, so it's every 3 years and there's 16 nations competing.
Really?
In Melbourne.
There's 16 countries around the world that play Aussie rules.
Oh, Jeff, you know, it's my passion and it's just grown the last 10 years. I'll quickly name them. Canada, USA, Finland, Sweden, New Zealand, Papua New Guinea, Japan, Denmark, Finland, Samoa, India, the Pommies, of course, and the Israel and Palestine are combined for a team. South Africa.
What? Yeah.
South Africa have got 15,000 kids apparently playing in South Africa and Nauru. So there you go, 16 teams in Melbourne starting tomorrow.
Israel and Palestine are playing together on the same team. How about that?
Yeah,
Aussie rules has made it happen. That's incredible.
Oh, that's a good thing, isn't it?
Now,
good to see a bit of peace.
Without getting all racial, but what's the Japanese Aussie rules team like, mate? I mean...
Funny you ask that. Last year in Vancouver, we had a big event, and Canada played USA, and Canada beat USA for the first time. And we always have our BC Footy Cup, which is two Vancouver teams, Calgary, Seattle. And last year, Japan came across. It was mostly the Aussie boys, but yeah, the Japanese are playing. And funny enough, a kid from Adelaide's over there, Andrew Khan, used to play a bit for Paranka. He's a coachman, so you never know who you run into when you're overseas.
Now, what were they like? Were they all right?
Oh, yeah, they were all right, but I don't think they're going to win. They won't win it. The tip's to win it. I mean, obviously, I think Canada's going to do really well. USA... probably Ireland again, and Papua New Guinea is a big tip again, because apparently quite a few of their boys are playing in Australia at various leagues.
Oh, I see. Right, okay. Yeah, now, do you ever see the day when AFL could go international, you know, soccer-like, but be the true international sport? Is this just the beginning, or is this a bit of fluff around the edges?
No, it really is exploding, and kids that play over here, the Canadian boys and the USA guys that stick around, they love it as much as anything. I mean, you know, we're a little bit tougher here, and some of the boys sort of tougher up with injuries, and that includes some of the Aussies over here as well, but the guys that stick it out totally love it. And I'll quickly talk, this is probably a good story now to relate, the coach at Canada, Mark Block, he started playing Aussie rules footy in Toronto after he saw Jacko on one of those commercials.
Oh, fantastic. Oi, you mean that Jacko?
Yeah. He just said to me, he says, Mick, once I saw that commercial and saw that game, I had to start playing. He went on to win two best and fairest, like the Brownlow Medal of Toronto, as a Canadian playing against Aussies. Now he's coaching Team Canada, and what he lacked, he's only been involved for, say, 10 years compared to if an Aussie was coaching of 30 or 40.
Yeah.
But what he lacked in only 10 years of experience, he makes up for in dedication, and all the Canadian boys are right behind him. They all play together because 90% of the team is from Toronto. We've got some out here from the West to make it up. But really look at Botch Canada. As being up there in the top four.
All right. So it starts tomorrow. Is it on the MCG?
No, they're playing the grand final as a prelude to one of the AFL games in a couple of weeks.
Okay.
So they play in Melbourne, and then they're playing some games in Warrnambool as well, which is, you know, obviously gets on the country people.
Well, it's a hotbed of footy activity, Warrnambool, you'd have to say. Obviously.
Well, all down south.
No, it's all
anyway, Adelaide, Perth, Melbourne, all we live for, right?
Absolutely. Now, recently you caught up with one famous Canadian.
It's Pamela.
Pamela, thank you. Yes.
She's our most famous export. I mean, a lot of people think she's from America, but she grew up in Victoria, just off of Vancouver, the island out there, and she actually got discovered at a BC Lions game, which is the Canadian Football League, and they showed her on the big screen when she 16, and the whole crowd went berserk, and she got discovered by the brewery, and then obviously she went on to Playboy.
It's a real fairy story, isn't it? Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, it's a great story, and, you know, I grew up in Gawler South Lions there, and then coming here to play, support the BC Lions. It's a good story, and yeah, I've run into her a couple of times.
So, in terms of, is she a blonde, bimbo-y thingy, or, you know, actually, or quite a savvy marketable thing who knows, okay, here's the image I need to portray, I'm going to do that.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you see her now on some of the TV shows. She's quite funny, actually, and she's had a comedy TV show recently as well. So, she's, you know, a lot of it show, and she obviously is a good mother as well. Her past has kind of gone behind her a bit. She just falls to the wrong guy every now and then. But no, she's a famous Canadian, and at the Grey Cup here, which is the CFL Super Bowl or AFL Grand Final, she was the parade marshal, and I got to have a bit of a chat to her, and she laughed at what I did. So, yeah, it was a lot of fun to meet her, and she's a really famous Canadian, and all the women over here really look up to her, which is kind of cool, I suppose.
In a weird, twisted, alternative universe sort of way. Hey, yeah. Mick Ozzie, it's always good to catch up. I'll talk to you again next week.
All right, good talking to you, Jeff.
And by this time, now, look, just back on the International Cup of Aussie Rules Football, how soon before, when's the grand final for that?
Yeah, well, it lasts like 2 weeks.
There's
four divisions and three or four games each, and then the final. So it goes for a couple of weeks over there in Melbourne. And I was talking to this guy from Perth, Griller, who comes over and commentates the US Nationals, and he says that Melbourne media are right behind us, so now check out afl.com.au or my site, always got links to different events. And, you know, Kevin Sheedy is the hugest advocate of international football ever. I was lucky enough to interview him last year, so good on Kevin Sheedy.
Terrific. All right, Mick, thanks for that. I'll talk to you next week.
Good luck. Thanks, Jeff.
Good on you. That's Mick Ozzie in Calgary. And there's a link to his website on the Jeff Berzikot page at 5AA.com.au. Back after this.